uno de los puntos más preponderantes es la metodología que nos enseñaron dentro de la maestría, cómo poder empezar a ver desde el punto de vista personal del usuario y no nada más del punto de vista como cliente o como mesías que es el que patrocina los proyectos, sino desde el punto de vista personal del que va a tener el uso, el usuario o este espacio a desarrollar.
Algunos tienen que ver, por ejemplo, con el aprendizaje de software, que tiene que ver con sistemas de información geográfica. Entonces, para varios proyectos de escala urbana, pues es ahorita fundamental el contar con dichos conocimientos.
El hecho de estudiar la maestría me aumentó los conocimientos y por ende pues me generó más confianza, más seguridad en mí misma para poder seguir desarrollándome como profesionista independiente.
Yo estudié la maestría en ciencias con orientación en gestión e innovación del diseño y bueno, como su palabra lo dice, gestión es algo que hago todos los días en mi trabajo. Asimismo, la metodología con la que nosotros trabajamos a lo largo de los semestres, a mí me ha ayudado mucho a resolver esas áreas de oportunidad que surgen día a día.
Los principales retos a los que me enfrenté fue por el proceso de investigación a la etapa de recopilar información oficial, el dialogar o entrevistar personas encargadas de algún puesto o de algún departamento, digamos, estatal o gubernamental. Digo, más que nada por la inexperiencia, ¿no? Ese podría decir que fue el principal reto.
Por ejemplo, ciertas circunstancias que vimos durante el periodo de la maestría, como factibilidades de proyectos, el porqué de ciertas circunstancias para construir un proyecto, son cosas que a lo mejor después de egresar de la licenciatura no tienes muy presentes.
Hi everyone, and welcome to the second day of the third International Forum of Knowledge. Today, I'm pleased to introduce you to three great friends we met this year. Ariana, Luke, and Silvia are close collaborations this year we had with the Polytechnic of Milano. We met in different academic activities. We were invited to participate in the workshops they organized to celebrate the 10 years of their Master of Design for Kids and Toys in the Polytechnic of Milano. And so I'm really glad to present them to you, and I'm going to read a little bit of their bio. So, well, Ariana Vignati. She's an expert in international research projects and in particular in the setup and development of European projects. She is expert in design thinking, strategic design, and human-centered design applying to the management of innovation process in various fields. Service innovations in the field of creative and cultural industries, product serving systems, innovation in SMEs, and big companies, business model generation in startup companies. Luca Foyce. After a long time experience as a product designer maker, mainly in wood, for big global brands, and intense commitment in planning and managing important communication projects in the design and territorial engagement fields, both in Italy and abroad, he's today creative advisor in strategic and special communication projects and contracted professor at Politecnico di Milano, Faculty of Design, Events Design, and Design for Kids and Toys class. Thank you, Professor. And Silvia D'Ambrosio, research fellow at C-Lab, Creative Industry Labs, collaborating and active co-designing with institutional partners and cultural and creative companies at national, European, and international level, with a particular focus on applying and testing of strategic design approaches and design thinking methodologies, graduated in product service systems design and Politecnico di Milano, and in design for kids and toys. Well, I'm really glad to have them here, and I'm going to share with you the screen now. Professor Foy, I think you're first. Your microphone, Professor.
Yes. Sorry, but his voice is not foie. I am from south of Sardinia and not French. But it's also foie is okay, no problem. So, who moved the slide?
I will.
So, I have a first moment to explain something about who we are, but also why we are working in this field, you know? And we work at in the design for kids and toys since 2004. Why this? Because it's amazing, but until 2004, there was nobody that speak about design and kids in a complete approach. There was designer that do something for kids, but was some cases, not an approach, a systematic approach. So we start to speak about to join the word design and the word kids, in particular toys, because the design for toys is the most problematic and most difficult and most complex product for kids, and is not only product, but each toy is also a system of product and service. So we start, but in a very simple way to join the two worlds, design and kids and toys. And we are surprised that also in this period that many companies dedicated to kids don't use it, this word, because the product of kids are designed by the technical office or some engineer in the company, or some parents that are working in the school for the little company, but nobody speak about design. Design was for furniture, for a technical project, for other kinds of product, but also food design, cake design, yacht design, every kind of design, but not kids and toy design. So we are happy to say now that we are the first that joined these two words. But it's not only a vocabulary problem, but was really to promote in the toys company the design thinking, the design approach, the design culture and method to product and services for kids. So this is something that is very important, because really we think that each design for kids is a system. Because it's not only the function, it's not only entertainment, it's not only play, but it's also something related to the brain of the children, to the evolution of the children. So it's something that is related, I don't exaggerate, to the society. Because different experiences in the kids in the first year have many kind of consequences, you know, when we are adults. So we are sure, we have no data about this, that if we work very good in the first 1,000 days, but also in the other year, in the education, in the evolution of the kids, we have less criminal when they are adults, or less stupid, or less, less bad person, bad human the kids will grow. So it's sure that the influence of the environment, the family environment, the social environment, the educational environment have important consequences as the genetic origin of the children. So our brain is plastic, and the children have a white brain in the beginning. So we have to write good story in the brain, good experience. Good experience create better kids create better men and women, and better men and women create a better world. This is sure, is a scientific demonstration. I have not the number, but we are sure of this. Then, what is design for kids in the daily situation is also a very big market. So the government, the family spend so much money in design for kids, in particular in the toy design, you know? So it's really something very, very important, no? And but the most part of this money is not invest in the right way, because we are is a market, is not only the unique market, but is the market in which the repetition of standard solution, standard toys is so hard. So is the most part of the market is very traditional, without a design approach, without value, without really sense of this object, these toys or this service. So it's very important to promote the design approach in the kids market, in the and is a very big market. So many resources are invested in the market. No, you can see this data. So it's really very important. It's not only toys, it's playground, TV, magazine, cinema, video games, books, stationery. So it's very important that we all the resources will have to be invested in the right way. And design is the leverage for quality, to give sense to the product, to the services, to the system of product and services for children. This is the main approach that we like to promote. And each county can do this in different way, because children is a universal aspect of the world, but really is something very interesting, because different culture, different approach can help each other. But the problem is also to create a very good connection in the world. We are building this kind of network. Many years we are building this kind of network. No? We write also a manifesto, an international manifesto in English, in Chinese, and Italian, to create the base of a discussion, of the worldwide discussion about the criteria, the value, the mission of Design for Toys. So this is important to know, because we are also, is not only philosophy, is a philosophy, but is a philosophy in a real market. And to join the value and the object is very important. It's not only marketing. The design in for kids have to work a little second before the marketing. And this is important, because all the company thinks to the marketing. And be careful. The kids market is the only, the unique market in the world in which the user is the little, but the buyer is an adult. So the company, what they said, to manage the marketing that said to the adults, not to be careful to the kids. Design, one of the fundamental of design is to put the user as a person in the center of the research. So design for kids and toys is this simple principle, to put the children as person in the center of our research, because this is very important. And you know, the market is so big. Our mission is teach, do, and innovate. This is really what we are doing for many years, and to connect all the passion and enthusiastic people in this. Because in many years we discovered that the passion is really the first motivation to have a correct relation with the children. Because the passion can also have the force to observe and to hurt the children, as the United States Declaration, Article 12, say, the kids have the right to be observed and to be heard. This is very important. So teach, do, innovate. This is something that is our approach in design, not only a project, but a complex approach. So our mission is to create really an ecosystem around the kids, because play and playfulness is something that is related to our life from zero, and from before to zero, to the end of our life. Because our brain use the play system, the mirror neurons, the memory, the capability, the mobility system, the neural system. Playing is something that create our brain, our personality, our identity, is the tools and the language in which we discuss with other. We have the relation with the reality and with the other, parents, but society. So it's really, play is not something secondary. Ah, you play. No, Play is more important than to work. Play is more important than business. Play is more important for everything because it's something related. The base of our relationship is to play. This is important. And our brain lives playing in all the age, not only when many times the children, because it's the language in which our brain take information and grow and create the personality. But also in the life, to play is important. To have a playful approach. This is really something that we are determined to develop. The problem is really something related to the culture and the approach of the market, but the approach also from the family, from the adult, from the buyer. We have to change this in a better. Because remember, we make many research, and we are sure that the ask in the market to better product and better quality for children is more and more important than the offering by the company. So we have to work in this sector to stimulate company, but also consumer, to a better kind of product for children. The solution is design, to an approach of complex design, because it's not easy, sure, but day by day, solution by solution, we can build another approach in the world. Because remember, the children is the unique part of the future that is living now. The other things, the future is the future. We have not now, but the children are the future now. So we have to work in a good relation with the future. We have to think to the future. So we have to think to the children. So this is our mission. You can change the slide. Thank you. And what's behind this voice blah blah? This is a network. many networks and many things that we have done in different scale, big, little experience, very large experience in the world, workshop being with 6-7 universities, 60 students from 60 countries. So it's really some very big and large network and very specific experience, because we work in the little scale and the big one, not because it's, and building a really very interesting and international network. This is what we like. And this year, next year, 22, in the end of 21, but end of 22, we have to consolidate the network of ambassador of the manifesto and all people that are passionate in this kind of value and mission. This is our effort for the next year, and we ask to be helped by each people that understand the strategic importance of kids. Not only rational, love and rationality, because our brain have the two parts, emotion and sentiments one side and rationality in the other. So we have this kind of approach to use a natural approach to kids, but to use design approach. So this is one of the most tools that we have. In this year, we have built the International Master in Design for Kids and Toys. And after the master, that is a very complex and transversal master with many skills and competence and many experience also with the company, because we are working with the most important company in Italy and in the world. Then you can see after the brand of this company, we are working to create a toy designer, and the toy designer, kids and toy designer, are able to not only to create product, but to create services, to make laboratory, to make to become pedagogist, to become interior designer, to become interior designer for a school, many, many kinds, consultant for public municipality, to solve the garden for kids, to work with the kids in the center of the research, and to work also with the adult related to the kids. So kids are a system, are not only a target. Remember, target is something no good, because it's a military word. There are better to say stakeholder, not target. Target is something to keep. So we don't like these terms. They are stakeholder. but the kids are a systematic stakeholder, are related to many other factors. So we can go on, and this master is very important. Is managed by Poly Design, and you can see Arianna is the director. I am co-director, and Silvia is the how to say in the column is a very important column of this. He was a student. He becomes a kids and toy designer, and then we was very lucky that helped us to build and to grow. Also this year, because it was the 10th anniversary of the master, and we create 4 international workshops, and Silvia became crazy to manage this different time in from Australia to China to Mexico and in Italy, and to use very good software to manage all this kind of works. It's very, very interesting. And I think it was very hard for her and also for the student in some moments, but was really rich experience, no? Very rich for everybody, no? Because it's so interesting. I cannot use another one. It's so interesting and new. And also me that I'm very, very old, because I have 143 years. 44 or 43 years, because I lived double my life. So I am very, very old. I daily in this kind of workshop, I learn many things. So I'm happy and lucky to participate to the workshop, because we learn many things now for different culture, for different, and working with younger people is really something very important in this period. So this is the story of now. This is our network, but is a little part of our network, because I don't know now how many people we can say in our network. We have to do, but it's a work now. And we like to create this network more and more. We have, you can read some number, 10 counties in 80 universities, 2,075 students this year, 40 professors and coaches that were part of this amazing journey. So this is number, but attention, is not quantity, it's super quality. The quantity is very interesting because it's related to the quality, because a different country, different culture, different experience was very amazing, and really a correct, the approach is very correct for speaking about kids, because kids are universal, in each country are the kids. But now in the globalization, the rules about what is global and what is local is not so easy. And so this kind of network is really, really something very living, very real, very important, very strategic, and to teach and learn. This is really something that we like. You can see the logo of many companies. There are a global company and in different kind of toys. And day by day, also in the future, we have to work not only in toys, but in kids and toys. Because, but toys is the center, because if you are very good in the toys market, you can design everything, because the other products are easier. But remember, toys is a system, is not a product, because create experience, create knowledge, create identity, create relationship, and so is really something systematic and not only a playing object. Thank you. I think that I say something for you.
Thank you, Luca. I want now to explore much more the structure of our master, and in particular the system of Politecnico, because it's quite complicated, but I'll try to be simple. Because in Politecnico di Milano there is a School of Design, which is in charge for courses for the degree, but there is also another structure called PolyDesign that is in charge for postgraduated programs and for courses and specializing master, which are not Master of Science, but are program with less credits, 60 credits, but able to create a specialization for graduated students with bachelor. Inside PolyDesign, there are a lot of services and products. There are masters, there are courses with a lot of professors and experts involved, not only from Politecnico, but also from other disciplines, from other universities, from other countries. And it is a real flexible structure able to support professors in develop teaching activities for graduated students for a specializing program addressed to be more focused on job and on the market. Inside this big part of Politecnico, there are a lot of master in different fields, and these are only the masters in design, focus in design, because we have other plenty or masters in other fields, engineering, architecture, but only in design we have a specialization in product design, business design, fashion design, and inside the field of product design, we decided to create this specific program in design for kids and toys. Its focus in product design, but with a real strategic approach, because we want to stress the capacity to design to be to develop product service system. Then in our program, we support students in learn a strategic design approach and a specific design thinking method applied to the development of product and services for kids. Toys is one part relevant, but it's one part of our program. We are opening to other fields like fashion, furniture, food, and so on. And in 2015, we started with a blended learning approach. When COVID, when no one knows COVID, we started to learn, first of all, to learn for us how to teach with online. And we decided to move the theoretical part of our master online with a very open approach to our students. They can use our platform when they want. They can learn the theory when also performing their professional activities, and combining this online part of our master with the practical moment thanks to the workshop activities, and finally have an internship, a real hands-on experience inside the company or as a freelancer or part of a research team. This is more or less the structure of our master. We have a first part of more or less 5 months in e-learning with the 7 modules, with the 20 micro modules, with the 30 professors and a lot of disciplines from pedagogy to marketing, materials, not only design. And it's extremely important especially for people with a bachelor in design that need to have a wide range of disciplines to perform projects in the kids' world. Then this very amazing moment for our students and also for other students of the university partners during the workshop, it's a real practice-based moment in which our students can apply tools and methods in real projects from four companies. Then it's not an ideal design process, but it's a real practice project with the collaboration of companies. And then the last step of the journey in our master is an internship, usually very connected to the workshop. Sometimes the results of the workshop are interesting for the companies, and then they want to continue to develop the concept, and the internship is a very interesting opportunity for our students, and a lot of our students start to work in the company in which they perform their internship, because there is a logical connection between workshop, internship, and then opportunity to start a job. It's a first level specializing master, because we can only graduated students can apply for the master, but it's also a good connection for Master of Science programs. We are developing a connection between the credits that our students gain for our master, 60 credits, with the 60 credits they need to have for the Master of Science. Then it's a new approach to the lifelong learning experience. The faculty is very wide, with a lot of professors, international professors, and also professors from different disciplines, from marketing, technology, ICT, materials, production, psychology, pedagogy. Then it's an opportunity to have a multidisciplinary experience. The ingredients of our master are, it's an international opportunity because our students are from all over the world, and also because we create international opportunities thanks to the workshop, and after Silvia will tell you much more about our workshop. It's a blended learning experience because it combines online and e-learning with the face-to-face activities. And it's collaborative because, especially during the workshop, the students are forced to work together in team, and especially to work in interdisciplinary teams with the designers, experts in psychology, marketing, economy, and so on. And it's a real opportunity also for students with a graduation in other disciplines, like, for example, engineering, to start to have a design thinking approach, especially in this field. Okay, so, the core of our approach is what Foyz said before. We put the children at the center of our process, of our innovation process. And it seems something normal, but I can say that it's not normal. It's something that we started a lot of years ago, and it's becoming relevant for all the companies that are producing products in the field of kids and services and products for kids. And another very relevant part of our approach is that the children is inside an ecosystem of adults, and not only parents are contributing to their to the growth of children, but there are a lot of other adults, of course, relative, but also caregivers, the teachers, pedagogies, and so on. But another interesting point is that also companies are part of this ecosystem. They have a responsibility in develop products and services able to solve needs and desires of this ecosystem of adults, and with the children at the center of this innovation process. This is more or less what we teach at the beginning to our students, and we force them to immerse themselves in this approach with a very concrete approach in observe people, interview people, make research. Okay, e-learning, I said that before, we started in 2015 to prepare the theoretical part of our master in e-learning, and thanks to an accessible platform and a flexible approach, we developed this specific set of didactic modules that our students can follow and can they can have their learning experience also with some exercises and some materials they can use to explore much more this topic. The second part of our master are the workshop, and Silvia after will explain much more, but they, as I said, they are a real practical moment in which students applied method tools in a real world situation with the direct contact with companies. Here you can see some examples of projects from our workshop. Every time students start from a brief of the company, they follow a specific process from research to concept to development in order to arrive till the prototyping phase and the test with the kids. And this is the most important part of our process, because our students can learn with the direct contact with the kids. They can learn if their solution is feasible, but also is something that children really need. The professional internship is the last part of our journey, but again, it's project-based, because we ask two companies to select a specific project in which include our students, and it's an opportunity to start to work inside companies with specific teams in the development of products or services. But sometimes our students collaborate also with us in research activities, in research projects, in innovative research projects, and they can also explore not only the traditional opportunity, job opportunity inside company, but also the opportunity to become startupper or also start to think about research and complex projects. it's more than a master. Our program is more than a master because we usually organize a lot of activities around our master events, showcase, exhibition, party with the children. And here you can see only few pictures of activities we did in this last 10 years. Because we want to create opportunities, first of all, to share knowledge and methodologies and tools, but also opportunities for our students and for the community of our ex-students, because we want to engage every day much more companies and designers in our community and in our approach. And I can say that even if COVID stopped something, of course, events, last year and this year, we organized events, physical events in Milan in the short period in which COVID allowed us to have this moment. About the job opportunity, we have more or less three main areas for our students. For freelance, the opportunity to become a freelancer is of course one of the most interesting, because they usually our students want to work in with a wide perspective, with the different sectors, with different companies, with the more creative approach. And sometimes they start with their own startups. We have maybe six or seven startups that our students created with the successful with a lot of success and successful results, but also of course employed in companies in this sector. You can see the picture of our student the first day with Clementoni, a very important company in Italy. And it's, I can say, it's not simple to enter in this company. And now this, the big company in this sector are asking us only students from our master, because they are sure that they have all the knowledge, the competencies and experience they need to be qualified for this kind of job. Some very excellent results of from our master, because we are proud to say that two projects developed during the workshop are now products in the market. The first is mix and match of Ravensburger, developed by two our students 2 years ago in a workshop, and also Rocket Air from HP, again developed by a couple of our students 2 years ago. The time of the development of these products is not immediate, especially during the COVID. 2 years is more or less the period the company needs to develop products, but we are sure that next year other products will be on the market from concept of our students. And another very successful result is from our team of students that performed a crowdfunding campaign on Kickstarter in July, and the campaign was successful. They was funded, and it's amazing because they met each other during the workshop. Now they are a team, they are a startup, and they are becoming entrepreneur with a very interesting set of products. I think it's enough, and I leave the floor to Silvia to explain much more about our workshop.
Thank you. Thank you, Professor Vignati and Professor Feuss, for this general introduction about our values and the structure of the master. Just let me tell you that this speech doesn't want to be a propaganda or a call to action. I mean, it can be, but we want also to take this opportunity to show you our learned lessons about this emergency of the pandemic that we all had to face during the last 2 years, because in somehow this pandemic has also positively impacted our way of working and learning and studying and collaborating with each other. I mean, thanks to these workshops, which are very special to us, we met lots of people, lots of friends, as Oscar mentioned before at the beginning of the webinar. So we really decided at the end to pursue and to continue to offer this kind of blended learning opportunities that we started, of course, as Professor Vignati said, many years ago, by including the e-learning section, then the two design workshops, and then the professional internship. But then during the COVID situation, we had to really think about and innovate the design workshops, because we couldn't be together physically inside the same classroom and so on. So we tried to break out the rooms, the doors, the windows, the physical space of the classroom, in order to try to offer to our students and classes the best learning and practical experiences by collaborating and creating networks with all many different universities and cultures from all around the world. And then after, I mean, since this year and then the next year, we are going to start the fourth edition of the master. We are including and we will offer again a blended international experiences and opportunities, because we really discover the power and all the potentials of this kind of asset of learning and doing with a blended modality. So both online and offline, by offering a strong collaboration among not only the students and the teams, but most importantly, by including all the different stakeholders inside and outside the academia. For instance, this academic year was special because we celebrated our third year's anniversary, and we decided to really make the most of it by offering four different workshops instead of two curricular workshops, when we really tried to include different companies and brands and different universities from all over the world. As you said a few slides before, thanks to this new asset of collaboration and participation, we really were able to engage more than 40 coaches, students, more than 300 students in 4 months. And that was an amazing experience. As Professor Feuss said before, I was a student of the Specializing Master in Design for Kids and Toys of the first edition. And then thanks to their interest and my passion, we started to collaborate in order to support and guide and follow all the path behind this master. And thanks to the different kind of participation among the different cultures and universities, we were able to set up 4 different briefs offered by 4 different companies, Ravensburger, Clementoni, Kiko, and AP, which are Italian, but even international brands. So also the briefs really offer a wide open mindset and opportunity to put in practice all the e-learning modules that we offer during the e-learning section, the beginning of the master. Of course, by following the speech of the two directors of the master, at the center of these workshops are 2 main, let's say, pillars or values. We want to design and innovate all the artifacts that surround the child. So toys, plays, places, furnitures, food, services, laboratories, fashions, events, and so on. And that means for us designing a product service system, not only a toy, where the toy, the products is only a small part of all the system and the structure and the strategic point of view that belongs to the company, but most importantly to the designer itself. And then, of course, we always put the child at the center of the creative process. You will see we adopted and we innovate different tools and methods from human-centered design, design thinking, systemic design, strategic design, in order to really offer the best aspects of learning and practical experiences that put in contact the students with the company and with the final users, of course. Then, of course, the International Blended Workshop was organized according to the time slot that we had available, at least 1 month or more or less. And we tried to also leave the stage to all the invited universities, which contributed with lectures and revisions. And most importantly, we put together and mix and match a little bit all the teams from all the different universities in order to collaborate in the so-called hackathon that were special events that last 1 or 2 days maximum, where really we forced and support and foster and boost the teamwork, but the international teamwork in order to respond to the three main phases of the human-centered design and development, of course, inspiration, ideation, and implementation phase. So we followed a specific path and journey, and we really tried to set up a calendar according to the different time schedules and time zones. And we were able to set up also a common and shared repository online and totally accessible from all the participants, both the students, the professors, the experts also, run lectures and reviews, both real time or via pre-recorded sessions. Most importantly, of course, we had the opportunity to experiment and explore a lot of different tools and platforms, both online and offline. And as Professor Vignati said before, we were also able to exploit much more than before the COVID situation, all the physical events that Milan can offer during the last month. We used many different platforms and tools in order to support the sharing, the different exchanges, the co-working, the co-design sessions among the different cultures and countries. We really were able to host students from Spain, China, Mexico, Argentina, Brazil, India, Australia. I mean, we really were able to connect and build a strong, even a stronger network by putting together and to create lots of different channels and communication among all the different actors. So not only professors, but students, external experts, and so on. We use, of course, Teams that we are using today for this webinar in order to run video calls. Slack, which is a super tool that get able to open specific channels for specific topics and discussions. WeChat, of course, in order to include and invite our Chinese friends. Miro and Mural, that are collaborative platform online that help us to run brainstorming sessions on co-design sessions, in other words, to play with digital post-its. And then I'm going to show you very quickly some insights that are very important to all of us. Because of course, we as professors and tutors and coaches were like facilitators and moderators of these different exchanges among the universities and the students. We designed and innovate all the tools that we are used to use physically inside the classroom in a digital point of view, and we discovered that the students itself started to find the best strategy to communicate with each other, to get to know each other better, to really also basically organize themselves. And so they use post-its and boards and templates also to support each other and to exchange suggestions or even greetings. Of course, some nudges had to be designed precisely in order to support, again, the involvement and engagement of all the different students. Consider that each workshop has at least 40, 60, 90 students per time. So we had to manage a huge amount of different expertise, of different backgrounds. And so all the templates and the online boards had to put everyone at the same level. Then we saw amazing feedbacks and comments and exchange. And also the most important fact, as Professor Foy said lots of time, I mean, at the basis of each student's entire design and in Design for Kids, there is the passion. There is really a particular behavior and attitude that is common to each of us, is the enthusiasm, is the passion that we share about this topic, which is very, very sensitive, which is very innovative, and which is really part of it, because each of us has been child for once. Then another insight that really make me laugh a lot still today is also that all the students during the calls, during the meetings, during the revisions and so on, they started to know each other better, to find the best strategy to collaborate. And so as a result was the contamination, the positive contamination and the cross dissemination among different languages and way of saying and so on. So it was really amazing how to see the participation of the students and to see the similarities and the differences among the cultures, especially also during the first lockdown that we ran the first international blended workshop that we named the Penta Workshop. We saw also some particular behaviors and attitudes that are still quite strong today. At least, okay, we were all behind a screen, a computer, a laptop, and so on, but we wanted to show our own world, our routine, our products, our toys, and so on. So, I mean, also running online design revisions or online lectures, if we have in common a specific mission, a specific value, a very strong commitment, I will say, the students and the professors, the faculty find the best strategy, which is spontaneous actually for being together. So for instance, here you can see some people from different parts of the world using the same background and so on. I mean, those small little parts that really make our heart bumping a lot, because we didn't expected some way of interactions and active commitment and participation. Then, as Professor Miniati said, we were lucky or clever, I don't know what to say, that we really always, in response to the COVID situation and in respectful of the health, let's say, regulation that our municipality had to put, of course, aside, we run different physical experiences also, play tests and coffee breaks and small events just to break out the room and to meet each other, to prototype together and to mix and match these two realities, the online and offline worlds. I want to leave you now with just the last two slides by showing some shots, some photos from the last event, our party that we ran last July to celebrate our anniversary. Because here you can see again different stakeholders all together, the company, the experts, the professors, the families, the children, playing together, testing together, exploring together, co-designing together, both the products designed by the students from the past editions, but then even exchanging some feelings and some new ideas and insight for the further concepts and developments. So thank you so much. And I hope that we respected a little bit the time slot that we were available. And if you have any questions, we are here for you. Thank you again, Oscar, and all the colleagues too, for inviting us today.
Thank you. Thank you so much. And I'm really, really, really glad that you can join us with this. And I'm now going to start reading some of the questions we have for you here. So I'm not going to read every one of them because we have a little bit of short time, but I'm going to send them the ones that not made the cut to you. I'm going to read the ones with the more likes. So, okay. We have here, have you developed products that facilitate socialization in neuroatypical kids or some investigation about it? I don't know who wants to answer that.
Maybe I can. Usually companies have not so much sensibility in this with these topics, but our students usually during their research discover these topics and opportunities, and the real value of our approach is that they start from these problems because they are problems, but they usually arrive at the end to develop solutions that are for all, the children, also for who has this kind of problem, but also for who has not problem but can take advantage for a new playing activity. I think the most important value of our approach is to push students in this direction, because companies are have not sensibility to develop specific products for these specific problems. But if you develop a product that solves this problem, but it's for all, it's fantastic.
Thank you. Thank you, Oriana. Now I'm going to read the next one. How are you dealing with the fact that nowadays it's more common to see kids playing with technology and apps rather than playing with plastic or wooden toys? I think we share some of this in the workshops.
So our position is the best possible balance. We don't demonize the technology and not emphasize the manuality. Depends on the contents, it depends on the year, how many times, it depends on many different situation. It's obviously that it's not so good in the first time to give immediately the technology in the hand. This is normal, but it's normal as to don't give a knife in the hand of the children. So we have to use the good capability to make a balance, because we cannot separate children from the technology, because it's something stupid, but we not also try to emphasize only the manuality, no? Because now the manuality is also to make this one. So is important the balance and the how many times and the quality of the experience, the contents, because there are also some video game for children of 6, 7, 8 years that are very interesting for as a father and son for the Museum of Archaeology. No, we can learn with the game. So the gamification can be a tool with the technology. And now is a very good trend is to put imagine books or physical table games with an app. So to mix, because also in the COVID, some things that we have observed is many children continue to play with the friends with the app, because it was impossible to physically meet them. So it depends. It's not something all good or bad. It depends of the relationship, the sense, the contents, and also the quantity, because the quantity becomes quality. No, so 1 hour is a problem, 3 hours is different.
Perfect. Thank you so much. Now there's another question here. I'm sorry, I lost it a bit. Okay, is it possible to design for kids the same age despite the different cultures that surround us? Is there any methodology about it? I think they're speaking in the world sense way. I don't know who wants to answer this.
Silvia.
I think, yeah, Silvia, you can answer. I say only things. Respect is the first condition. Yeah. Then we can mix everything.
Yeah, thank you. I mean, the methodology is our methodology, which is based, I mean, on a mix of different methodologies and approaches, the product service system design, the human-centered design, that allows you to really put in contact yourself, so you as a designer, together and directly with the final users. So by using our approach of exploring, ideate, implement, inspiring, and so on, you really get in contact with the direct and the final user many times during the creative process. And by doing so, you explore and collect qualitative and quantitative data according to the target, the range of users and stakeholders that you want to include or design for. If the challenge is to put together different cultures, I will say it's possible, of course, because as we said at the beginning, play and playfulness is a universal languages. Of course, the toys and the products are a little bit different in terms of colors, in terms of systems, in terms of interactions and so on. But then the way of perceiving the playfulness and the playability is the same. So of course, keep this challenge for your further and future projects, because I see that mixing and taking inspiration from different culture is really something that is valuable and potential for all, because it allows us to get richness from all the different perspectives.
And remember, in the story, there are many world traditional games in the story. Yeah, chess are something like this, different image, different identity, different color, different everything, material. But the is something universal to play, because it's related to our brain, and the brain is universal.
Thank you so much. And for the last question, I have this one. To whom do you recommend taking this master? Do you have to be in the design field necessary, or can be from other fields?
The second one.
Exactly. Silvia, and I mean, I can also share some fun facts that I was the student of the first edition, and then I had the opportunity to tutoring and following and guiding all the other editions. And each edition, each class is different. It's very multidisciplinary, because of course we have a multidisciplinary approach. And so we offer different disciplines, different sections, different experiences to different people. So for instance, you can find some students that are actually mothers, that are professionals, that are designers, that are not designers, engineers, chemists. I mean, they really came here not because of their own background, but because of their own passion. Really, it's something not related to philosophy point of view or so on. It's really, passion is something also that can be touched, that can be feel, and that connects all of us. So it doesn't care if you don't have a design background. I mean, actually, it's quite interesting to see how different disciplines can design together and develop together a product service system for children, because it allows you and all your team and your point of view to put together different expertise, different tools, different experiences, and so on.
Thank you so much for everything. And well, thank you for joining us in this afternoon for us and night for you. And thank you for your ability in your time. And well, we'll keep in touch and we hope we still have more collaboration with us. We well close this meeting today and thanks to everyone that was listening to this conference. Thank you so much again and hope to see you soon.
Thank you.
Absolutely.
Bye bye.
This was just the beginning. Ciao.
Yes.
Bye bye.
Thank you. Ciao ciao.
See you.